My dear students, good morning to you all. Now we have to see about the contrivances of cross-pollination. Contrivances of cross-pollination means they are collectively some adaptations, contrivance, the mechanisms formed naturally in plants, in the flowers of the plants, in order to avoid self-pollination and in order to promote cross-pollination. Those adaptations, those mechanisms naturally found in the plants are called contrivances of cross-pollination. The contrivances of cross-pollination is given as a flowchart here, and we'll see one by one. Contrivances first classified into dicliny or unisexuality, and second monocliny and bisexuality. The dicliny or unisexuality is further subdivided into monoecious and dioecious. For monoecious, these are all the plant which shows monoecious condition: coconut, bitter gourd, castor, maize, etc. In the dioecious condition, it can be seen in this plant, borassus, carica papaya, that form. This plant are the dioecious plant. Monocliny, that is bisexuality, further subdivided into four types. Number one, dichogamy. Number two, heterogamy. Number three, heterostyly. Number four, self-sterility. Dichogamy is further subdivided into protandry, example Helianthus and Clerodendron. Second one, protogyny, example Scrofularia, Aristolochia. And the heterogamy is not further subdivided. And the heterostyly is subdivided into dicliny, distyly and tristyly. Distyly example Primula, and tristyly example the Thyrum. Self-sterility is exhibited by Abutilon and Passiflora. For heterogamy also two examples given: Gloriosa superba and Hibiscus. Now we'll see one by one. Dicliny. What is dicliny? When the plants produce only unisexual flowers to prevent self-pollination and to promote cross-pollination, that condition is called dicliny. What is unisexual flower? Flower with andrecium, male flower. Flower with gynoecium alone, female flower. So, in a flower, when either andrecium or gynoecium is present, that flower is called unisexual flower. Unisexual flower is classified into two types, male flower and female flower. Male flower is called staminate flower. Staminate flower contain only andrecium. And second type is pistillate flower or female flower that contain only gynoecium alone. So plants which produce unisexual flowers comes under dicliny. The dicliny is further subdivided into monoecious and dioecious. Dicliny is always called unisexuality. It is further subdivided into monoecious and dioecious. What is monoecious? When a plant produces both male and female flowers, one at the same plant, that is called monoecious. The condition is called monoecious. Coconut, bitter gourd, castor, maize are the examples for monoecious condition. In these plants, both male flower and female flowers separately in separate branches are produced. In this case, in monoecious condition, autogamy is completely prevented, but geitonogamy takes place. What is geitonogamy? When pollination takes place, between the two different flowers of the same plant, that is called gitanogamy. So that is about monoecious. Come to dioecious. In some plant, only male flowers or only female flowers are produced. Male plant produce male flower, female plant produce female flowers. So in some other plant, two different plants can be differentiated, male plant and female plant. In the case of borassus, panaimaram, carica papaya, papadimaram, and dat palm plant, that is the three. In these three plants, male plant, female plant, separately we can see, that is dioecious condition. In dioecious condition, both autogamy and gitanogamy can be prevented, totally cannot be taking place in this plant. That is the dioecious condition. Come to monocliny and bisexuality. In the monocliny bisexuality, there are four conditions, there are four system, four classification is given. One is dichogamy, second one ergogamy, third one heterostyly, fourth one self-sterility. Now, first we will see about dichogamy. What is dichogamy? When a plant produces bisexual flowers, but anthers and the stigma mature at a different time. Anther first mature in some cases, or in some cases stigma will mature first in the flower in order to avoid self-pollination. So that condition is called dichogamy. Dichogamy, it is a condition in which plant will produce bisexual flowers. The bisexual flower contain both androecium and gynoecium, but that will mature, androecium and gynoecium will mature at two different times. That is, anthers and stigma will mature at two different times. That is called dichogamy. Dichogamy is further subdivided into protandry and protogyny. Protandry, example, helianthus and clerodendron. In helianthus and also in the clerodendron, the anther will mature first. Stamen mature earlier than the stigma. That is the condition seen in the helianthus and clerodendron. See the two diagrams given. Here the first diagram, anther mature first, that is shown. The stigma mature later. This is the example for protandry. Then second condition is protogyny. In some other plant, bisexual flowers are produced, but in the bisexual flower, first stigma mature first. First, stigma mature earlier than the stamen. In the case of scrofularia, these two are the diagram for scrofularia. The first diagram, it is shown the stigma first mature, later only the stamen mature. So that is the condition as far as the protogyny is concerned. Ergogamy, heterostyly and self-sterility we will explain in detail with diagram next class.